Arizona Secretary of State Michelle Reagan has launched a new website designed to help voters track the cash that fuels the state's political campaigns. The site currently has information for state and legislative candidates from 2013 on, with plans to add local and county races. Joining us now is Arizona Secretary of State Michelle Reagan. Good to see you again. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me back.
All right, campaign reporting website. What are we talking about here?
Yeah, it sounds boring, but it isn't. We're so excited about this. This is the first time that an average person will be able to get online and see an entire snapshot of the election spending in Arizona. It aggregates, it's easy to navigate. It's an absolutely amazing system.
So every campaign a donor has given money to that's on public record is there on this site.
Correct. And every expenditure that candidates make. You can jump from one thing to another. We already do all this reporting in Arizona as candidates and as political parties, PACs, everybody reports. But the information is really scattered. And you have to know exactly what you're looking for in order to find it. With our new program, See the Money, you're able to just get the same piece of information from multiple different ways. You don't need to know exactly what you're looking for.
So again, and I've heard some criticism. People say, this information already exists, no big deal. You're saying it already exists, but it's diffuse.
It already exists. It's very, very hard to navigate. Like I said, you need to know exactly what you're looking for. In addition, it doesn't allow you to compare or contrast candidates. It doesn't allow you to look at like things. It doesn't allow you to do searches. Big searches, like if you want to know where the majority of the money came from in a state or break things down. This current system doesn't allow, one thing that no state's done, and we'll be the first to do it, is all of the data in one place. So it does no good to talk about transparency if you're only talking about legislative candidates and statewide candidates. Some of the people running in city elections regularly out fundraise legislators, yet those reports are sometimes on paper, and they're in 91 different jurisdictions around the state.
Let's go real quickly now. If you go to the website, let's go to the homepage if we can, take a look at the homepage here, because when you go to the website, you have options on the homepage. You can search for candidates, you see individual donors there, you see a whole variety of things. We'll press the search for candidates there, and once you press that, you get to this kind of a curious looking grid of folks from left to right. Now, from left to right, that's the most money raised. Left to the right side is
right. And so that's another thing this site does that the current site doesn't do, is it presents a visual snapshot of spending in Arizona elections, of all of it, not just candidates, not just PACs, not just political parties, not just independent expenditures, all of it. And from that graph that you showed, you can go to, if everything in there is live, so if you were to click on something.
And let's go ahead and we'll click on, I don't know, how about Michelle Reagan? Yeah, let's click on Michelle Reagan. And when you do that, you come up with what?
You're coming up with everyone that I've accepted money from. So people who've contributed to me. And if you see something in that list that is, you know, somebody you want to know more about, you click on that person and it takes you to their page, and everyone they've given money to will be listed.
All right. Now, I can see one question coming out from this. What happens if on that list we have the Society for the Celebration of Puppies, and no one knows who's behind that? So how do we find, again, we're getting back to dark money here, which is a controversial topic in here. You've been right in the middle of this debate regarding dark money. How do we know that PACs and things, folks that are trying to hide, are we going to get any closer to finding that out through this?
A little bit more information. So what this site also does is it links with multiple other databases, something else that hasn't been done certainly in any state system. And so let's say you can click on PACs, any type of PACs, and find out the money in, the money out of normal political action committees. Of ones that choose to file with the federal government and consider themselves to be the nonprofits, the one that loves puppies, like you mentioned. Instead, what you're going to get, because you don't get actual donors from them, we pull their IRS 990s. So that's going to be right on the user's screen. And again, it is true that all of this is already public data, but people would need to know where to go find this. It would take hours of digging. Many times it's only on paper in some areas. And this, just in a couple of clicks and a couple of seconds, puts it right on, even on your cell phone.
This takes us back to Senate Bill 1516, which was quite the controversial bill, and again, something that your staff and you supported and helped design and create. At the time, it was suggested that Arizona was abdicating its responsibility for following this money, for putting lids on campaign donations. This website and the idea of following the IRS, the idea behind 1516 was federal government's responsibility. They can do a better job. Right. Let them do it. Are they going to do it? Can we find out if they're doing it through this website?
Well, as you know, transparency was really important to me, continues to be really important, and we determined the best way to provide transparency was through harnessing technology, giving people as much information as is out there in one place. And so 1516 actually had some wonderful components in it that we wrote, and it's what's called, without getting too geeky, a bright line test. And it's saying, if you choose to file with the IRS, you're right, the state doesn't have jurisdiction over you, but if you don't comply with all the rules that you've agreed to, IRS filings, Corporation Commission filings, then you are automatically deemed a political committee and therefore must report your donors. So this is something that I don't think, certainly some of the critics of 1516 didn't understand, or maybe chose not to understand exactly why we were writing 1516. And that was to decide what does the state have jurisdiction over and what do we not. And then for the first time, giving us, the state, a tool to use in case some of these groups break some of the federal laws that they say that they're going to be following. So that was a very big deal and something we're really proud of.
So again, if someone decides that they're supposed to be a nonprofit, but they haven't quite acted as if a nonprofit, they become something else subject to other jurisdictions.
Correct. So right now, those nonprofits are filing with the Internal Revenue Service, the IRS, on the federal level, and then they also need to file with the Corporation Commission. So they need to be completely current, so to speak, in all of their filings. And as long as they follow those rules, they're fine. They're under federal guidelines. But the 1516 added, but if you don't, you are now considered automatically a political committee and therefore must file your donors with the state of Arizona.
Will it be clear?
No state has that.
Will it be clear when they don't?
Well, that's the beauty of See the Money, is by giving people information and you don't have to go to multiple sources to look for it. You pull up something and it's right there. You can see, has this person filed their papers with the IRS?
This is a is this still in the beta process here? Still,
this is a beta, and we want to get as much feedback from people. Criticism is welcome, because this is something that, it's a program that I don't ever envision being complete. We can continually add to this. Pretty soon we're going to be adding lobbyist filing in there, so you'll be able to do searches for lobbyists. Start adding cities. Met with a number of cities who are so excited about this. Then when you pull up Ted Simons, you're going to see, let's say you contribute to people on the state level, we'll also see if you're also influencing people on city or county levels. That's the part that's never been done in any state. So Arizona's going to be the first.
How much did all this cost? I know there's been a stopping and a starting and a starting on all over again. What was going on with that?
Well, in a perfect world, I would have liked to have this done in my first year. We kept adding things and coming up with all these other things that we wanted it to do. So we budgeted about $1.5 million, mm-hmm. roughly. We're at about $700,000 right now that we've spent. And we still have a lot of things that we want to add to it that we know are going to be coming out in 2018 and hopefully 2019.
So the build out will be 1.5 or less.
Yeah,
million.
Rough. I mean, it's cheaper that we're doing it in-house, that's for sure.
And final version launches whenever it launches? I mean, whenever the beta is done with?
Well, we set no time frame on this. We're not obligated to, nobody obligated us to do this. And so any deadlines are just self-imposed deadlines. It's kind of a nice place to be. And so I've been very cautious to want to get it right and make sure that people have a chance to play with it. Let us know what they like, what they don't like. Since we're coding it right now ourselves, We can make it anything people want it to be. And, you know, it has capabilities to do things that the current law doesn't even allow us to do. So it's a really exciting project.
All right. So the Secretary of State website takes you there? Does it have its own address?
It's very easy to remember. It's called See the Money. So seethemoney.com.
Seethemoney.com, and you're there. And have fun. Spend
yeah,
the rest
and,
of your
and
night.
And mobile ready. So.
Okay. All right.
Send us feedback. We'd love to hear it.
Good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Nice to see you.